Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Rabi-Ribi. In the last episode, we, actually, I forgot what we did in the last episode. It's been a while. I'm so sorry, but between all the craziness that happened with the recent election and technical difficulties in actually trying to record what the heck... and trying to actually record this game, it's been a bit of a struggle. I actually plan to have a guest on my Let's Play and have him co-commentate alongside me, but it didn't take. So I'm doing this solo for now. So let's just pick up where we left off, and we're currently off to Rabi-Rabi Park to try and find some helpers to activate this delay. So let's go to that. That being said, since I've had multiple recording sessions completely and utterly foiled, this isn't exactly a blind part. It's been a while since I've played, but it's gonna take a bit of a memory on remembering on my part to figure out where everything all is. So let's see where we go from here. Oh right, this egg thing. Get out of the way. Right then, we'll just keep going and... odd. There's a save point all the way over here. I'm sure it's not anything important. Okay, Irisu is running away again, and this, fox girl is here. Did we know her? I like this line here. It keeps making me think this is some kind of online chat room. Even though it really isn't, but still, it's kind of amusing. Also, note the bit of a grammatical error there with the exclamation point and the period. Oh, jeez, really? We barely met the girl! Why are you picking a fight with us? Seriously. I'm gonna have to knock some sense into you. You and your carrot drill missile things. Oh, it looks like this battle's not gonna last for very long. Oops. Yeah, it's been a while since I fought this boss, so I'm a little bedazzled on how her attacks work. Oh, jeez. Uh-oh, here comes her special. Yeah, way to leave yourself open like that. Not bad. Well, in this case, it was warranted, because she came after us first. Does this mean there's like a fairy queen or something? Yep, they seem to have a habit of doing that. Well, again, she was the one who ran away from us, and we just met her. Jeez. Oh, well. Well, I guess we'll just move on with the rest of the plot. What's with all the bunny ear confetti? Yes, it is very pretty, but it's also very surreal. Is this perhaps an omen? This is awkward. Also, you done and borked your text up here, game. Yeah, I think someone needs to call tech support. The sky is malfunctioning. Not a lot of energy. We didn't take that much damage. Still, yeah, that's kind of irritating. So let's just go on. Blast our way through these enemies. And head on to... Oh, you are still there. Lovely. Get out of my face. Alright, so... We should be... Oh, wrong button. We should be in a... Rabi-Ribi Park proper. Furthermore, we can get ourselves a new upgrade. The Defense Girl Badge. So, this one's actually kind of useful for the early game, because... As you can see, it reduces all damage taken by 1 or 2 points. And since most enemy attacks usually don't do that much damage, it actually makes quite a bit of difference on the easier difficulties. And then we have this NPC here. She can either lower the difficulty for you, or raise it. But if you say no both times, she'll keep it as it is. And we're already on casual already. I hate saying that word. We're already on the easiest difficulty already, so... There's no real point in doing so. So let's just, just get rid of these enemies and... Oh, another cutscene. Hmm? Someone up ahead. Maybe there'll be a helper? Apparently our helper is a pair of, slippers. Oh yeah, that's right. We have to learn how to jump higher in order to get to save Ribbon's friends from earlier. So yeah, classic Metroidvania dilemma. We have to find a path to our item destination. So let's go find it. Also, expect me to be using the carrot bomb a lot here, because there's actually a secret area somewhere in this zone. Hopefully we'll find it before I forget about it, or we get too far of where it is. Oh great, these things are back. Yep, see? That Defense Girl badge is paying itself off already. Take that, stupid bee. Bees can be cute, but bees in video games are outright annoying. Also, get out of my face. Ah, nice. Hammer drill deals more damage. And we get a health upgrade. Just sitting there in the most obvious location ever. There was a bunny cultist ahead. And I think... Yep, this is the secret room I mentioned. And, there's that egg there. Yeah, spikes hurt, but... We got us, the very first Easter egg. There's 7 Easter eggs in this, in the island core. So we'll probably be seeing them, at a later date. That's the one thing I dislike about some of the classic Metroid games, is that they're not they're always obvious in where their hidden items are located. Let me hit you. There it goes, and it didn't die. Why? I guess it was too cramped of a corridor to hit that enemy in. Can't go that way, so I guess we gotta keep going up. Also, for the record, I don't know what the Easter eggs actually do, so, so, any information about those would be appreciated, if you happen to see this video and want to leave a comment. Just keep going along here. Shoot this enemy here. And jump! Get out of here. So we could keep going this way, but unfortunately, we can't quite jump high enough to reach this potion up here. Nor can we jump high enough to reach this ledge up there, so that's pretty much out of the question for now. Alright. So our next destination is to go down this here hole. Is this a dead end? Oh, here we go. Yeah, the classic 2D game cliche of us as a player not being able to see a secret passage, but they are able to see it just fine. Huh. Maybe there's someone that's willing to help us. Nope. Just bunny cultists. Get out of my face. And while we could go this way, we can't. We don't have anything to get us through a narrow passageway yet. No morph ball for us, I guess. And it looks like, judging by the music here, we discovered the bunny cultist's hideout, which is remarkably well furnished. Also, we have some new enemy types here. These little fairies here that shoot shots based off of card suits. Like this one shoots diamonds. And I got hit by one. Oops. Nothing there. What's in here? Looks like some kind of a healing spot. Useful, but I don't think it's what you'd call essential. So, let's just keep going. And we fight our mini-boss here. It's a bunny riding a Zamboni. A Zambunny. This one seems to love using these light-based attacks. Oh, jeez. Yeah, the key to dodging this thing is to start on the right side and then move to the left as it rotates. Otherwise, you're gonna get hit and you're gonna take damage. Hey, I got a C rank. And she's dead. And we have another enemy type, that exploding dice, and those fairies that shoot hearts everywhere. Also, I don't know what these pink-haired bunnies in suits do. They just kind of stand there and the... I guess they have more dangerous attacks on higher difficulties, but so far they don't seem interested in doing much. And our combo got broken. Lovely. Oh well. This one has some blue element attacks. I don't know if the color of the attack has anything in particular to act. Oh, right, I forgot, yeah. Yeah, stay away from the blue explosions the blue bunnies shoot. Unless you like taking a ton of damage. Take that. Yeah. Really, this is just a straightforward corridor of enemies. Ow. Pretty much a bog standard for any sort of a Castlevania-like game. Not much platforming, just enemies for you to fight. We get a mana up increase, and I'm probably gonna get hit. Yep, well, I got hit, but I didn't take any damage. I like this badge. This badge is helpful. Helps conserve a bit of health on the way. Nothing there. There's another healing spot here. It's over here. Weird. I guess that wall can't be broken with bombs. Alright, there's another enemy up ahead here. This one's green. This one you want to stand next to the laser emitter thing, because the lasers are going to be spread out. And that's it. That's all the bosses in this zone. And our reward is... bunny slippers! Yay! And if this is the case, then this cave here is basically the bunny cultist's shoe closet. Yeah. Now we have the bunny slippers, we can jump higher now. And we definitely want to go out of our way to go back to the cavern. Alright. Actually, there should be a warp stone just up ahead, if my memory serves me right. Yep, here's one. And this bridge will take... is this bridge? What's with this rope fixture here? What the heck? Anyways, yeah, we can use this warp stone here to return to the Spectral Cavern. And now we can go on our quest to save Ribbon's friends. Pretty straightforward, nothing to worry about here. Just gotta get past these enemies. Oh, wrong button. Oh, jerks. For that, you get a hammer to the face. Alright then, let's see what's beyond this passageway here. And what the heck? To quote Nozomi Weaver from Trauma Center Second Opinion, you gotta be kidding me. Well, we might as well see how high this goes up. Oh! Gives us a mana up! That's a plus! Though, this is yet another dead end. We can't go through here yet. If we can go through here at all. Oh, okay, there we go. Alright then. Let's go on in and see where we are now. What the heck?! First, we go from a park to an underground base to a shoe closet cave, and now someone decided to make some kind of technological bunker inside another cave? What the heck? And who is this girl over here? Huh. These must be Ribbon's friends. Speaking of that girl, I think she heard us. Oh boy. to Sayaro. Oh dear. Eep! She's gonna attack us! With the power of computer hacking! Yeah, there's not really much to this fight. She literally stays immobile for most of the fight. While these holograms up there shoot bullets at us. See how you like a orbital laser strike. That hurt, yeah! Oh dear. Yeah, it's alright to get a nice combo going on her while she's still immobile. Well, I'm sorry we broke your tech! You're right, this isn't over yet. Have at you! Oh, crud, she has laser guns too! Oh, pff, dang, she really doesn't wanna... Oh, what is she... Oh, great, this attack. You want to stand under her when she uses it, otherwise... she's gonna hit you. Whoa. Yeah, she's got a weird variety of attacks if, her guns and bullets and everything. And can I just say I love this boss theme? Oh, she's not low enough. What the- Oh, crud, she slowed us. That's a little inconvenient. And now she's packing grenade bullet things? I don't even know what to make of this. She's a dangerous character. Pretty dangerous for a nerd, that is. Oh, dang it, I just missed her. Fall. But punish her! Oh, jeez. Where? How are you supposed to dodge that? That's like completely unavoidable. Then we got. And our mana is depleted. Lovely. Yeah, she didn't give me nearly as much of a hard time the last time I fought her. And pff, she is just such a unpredictable little spaz. And here comes her super attack. But this makes her pretty much a sitting duck again. Uh-oh. Lasers out the wazoo! Seriously, she is just packing some serious heat and tech here, and she always messes with my jumps! And she messed so much I accidentally switched weapons while fighting her. This is so irritating. I'm gonna punish her the instant she comes down. Or she can completely land on me! Ugh! Good gravy! Well, how did this happen? You start attacking us first, and I had complete and total Let's Player curse running throughout the entire fight. Well, it is true that you have to defend yourself against bullies, but you could have taken a moment to listen to us, you know? Yeah. Just let the fairies go, and we can put this all behind us. Well, at least she's apologetic. Then we get a little cutscene here of the two reuniting, or three reuniting, excuse me.
I can count you guys, seriously.
Ah, right. Good question. Why is it in a cave? Okay, then fair enough. Oh, Cecini, don't you know? Any highly advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. With solid light holograms and everything. Well, at least she's not like that witch we met earlier. Yep, it's best to have some extra hands to cover more ground. That just leaves us with the science girl here. A maze. You do realize. It's besides, it's just a straight path to the warp stone. You're not gonna get lost. Oh well. And then the game cuts away so we can go back to town. And since he just charges off without another word. You're welcome! Okay, so it's a personal nickname for her. Fair enough. Also, I think I read somewhere that Ribbon's name is supposed to be a reference to the fairy Ribbon from Kirby 64 and the Crystal Shards, which is a cute reference. But in any case, now we're back in town. We might as well, see if there's any new developments. Cecini's not in a talkative mood right now, though. Okay, so we're fine. We're fine for now. So we accomplished two major goals in this video. We got some high jump shoes, and we got a new helper. But there is one other goal I wanted to do while I was out here. One I discovered while doing a previous recording. Just give me a moment. Oh, get out of my face. What is with these eggs? They're incredibly durable. Well, that happened. Well, in any case. Now we have the high jump boots, we can actually explore the park a little bit, and I realized I could have just teleported right over there. Whoops. Oh well, I need the extra money and experience. It's not a big deal. Sheesh, these enemies are getting more durable. Gotta level these things up, you know? Oh, you jerk! You're hiding right there! Oh well. And I can't make this jump for some reason. Whoops. Right then, so let's just continue onwards. Oh! Wait. Yeah, that leads to the cavern. Oh yeah, that's right, I just remembered. Okay, it's not this way, but... there was that, SP up I wanted to get. I pointed out earlier, but I couldn't get because I couldn't jump high enough. Get out of my face. You get out of my face! Everyone, just get out of my face! Why not? Overkill is fun. There we go. I'll have to buy some more stuff with the money I have. I have a fair amount of cash. Alright then, so if we go to the right from here, bash these baddies, get rid of you girls. Jump over this. Right, here is the place I was thinking of. Now we can get this mana up. Right. So if we go up here now, we should be able to reach this ledge. And unfortunately, we have a bit of a roadblock here. We still can't jump high enough to reach this ledge here. However, in my experimentations, I discovered there is a kind of a hidden wall jump maneuver here in this game. So let me see if I can pull it off. Oh my goodness! I got this first try on my first recording in like a week! That's amazing! I think it's like the classic kind of wall jump kind of maneuver where you have to just push towards the wall and then push away from it as you jump. I'm not entirely sure what the specifics are, but holy cow! That's amazing! And to celebrate, here, have some more carrot bombs. And, dang it. I want to leech more experience for these bombs. Okay, let's get out those bees out of the way. Yes! Now it takes even less time for a carrot bomb to explode. Very good. Hold still, dang you! Nice! Okay, that's good. Now we got rid of those, vile plume-like monsters. No, I'm pretty sure there's nothing else in here. Just to make sure. Excuse me. Uh-oh, it looks like Flux is kicking in, that's why there's lag right now. Forgive me. It's fall right now, and it's getting darker earlier, so... it's down here. Huh, looks like it's another badge. Can I fall down here without missing my target? Yes! Attack trade. So what does this do? Attack plus 25, damage taken plus 50. Eek! I can't even equip it right now, but that's some serious firepower right there. I mean, sure, I could equip it instead of the defense trade. Defense grow, excuse me. But I don't know. In these kinds of games, I feel like being more durable is better than being being more offensive. Because as you saw in the Sassini fight, I was not very good at dodging at all. So, whoopsie doodles. Okay, there's nothing there. Okay, we're good. Also, funny fact, funny story here. In that one room where I found that Easter egg, I decided to mess around a little bit and it turns out one of the bunny enemies fell into the secret room of all the spikes. And they got stuck there. They basically got really stuck there. And they eventually died, and I tried to get them to die on the spikes. Unfortunately, it seems like hazards only do so much damage to actual enemies. Come on, get down here. Okay, so, you may be wondering, why am I going this way? Shouldn't you be getting back to the main plot? Well, that's the thing about Rabi-Ribi. It's very much a very open, exploration-focused Metroid-esque game. Which is very good, because a lot of games claim to be Metroidvania-like games, but a lot of them have a very linear progression rate. This game, not so much. Oh! Would you look at that! I found a hidden item. Very good. I knew randomly tossing carrot bombs at everything would help. So we'll just shoot you two. And if we go this way, we'll find us a save point in this enemy here, which can't hurt us, but if we start attacking it... Yeah, we can start hitting it for to rack up a high score and high combo. Didn't even break 1,000 there, but I don't think it's a huge deal. I don't know if there's anything you can get from doing that, but hey, it's there. If you want to practice combos, that's a good place to do so. And if you're going to get a high rank on bosses, you definitely need to do that, but I'm not interested in that. I'm just interested in beating the game, collecting the items, and trying not to get hit by these enemy bullets. And the everything else around here. This place is very cramped. Hehehe. Alright then, so if we keep going up here, we'll eventually reach a new location. Now, what is this place? Oh, yeah, it's the Sky High Bridge. Definitely feels like we shouldn't be here yet, but like I said, Rabi-Ribi is very, very lenient when it comes to exploration. Way to interrupt my combo, you dumb... them fairy. Okay, so first things first, I want to look for the warp stone here so I can come back to this place later. Also, there are a ton of enemies here! Like, seriously, there's just... the place is just packed with them! Blammo. Hmm. Also, I don't know about you, but this background makes me think this area is kind of falling out of the sky. That's a little unsettling. But in any case, we have found a warp stone. Okay, this isn't anything special. Okay, so I am gonna warp back to Rabi-Rabi Town. And I will call it a session for here, for now. Alright then. Next time on Let's Play Rabi-Ribi, we'll continue exploring the Sky Bridge and see if there's anything of note up there. Spoilers, there probably is. Probably. Excuse my pronunciation, I've been tripping over my lisp for a while. So, in any case, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, have a good afternoon, evening, or whatever time zone you're in.